Next up, let's take a look at the global panel. It's at the very top. We'll start from the right and go left. On the very right, we have those pool selectors, tab through them. We can view them all at the same time as well. Below that, we have the mix view. Here we can look at all of our samples, edit them all in one window, as well as work with that master panel and master effects. Those pool selectors also give us some solo, mute, and volume control over those different pools. Next, we have the output. This is the master output of Iris 2. Next to that, we have intensity. Remember, the intensity is a transparent limiter directly from ozone. Next to that, we have glide or portamento. This works in mono mode, legato mode, and polyphonic mode. Next, we have the voice modes, mono mode, one note at a time. Legato mode gives us no reset on the envelopes, and polyphonic mode gives us more than one note at once. We can also limit the amount of voices to save on CPU. We can scroll through the presets using the arrows. And we can go forward and back with undo and redo. We can save a preset just like we did before. We can update that preset. We can create a new preset, which clears out everything as far as settings and samples. And then we have that random button that we used before as well. The option menu allows us to get under the hood. And finally, we have the help menu. This gives us some great resources in case we get stuck anywhere or want to learn more. And that's the global panel in Iris 2.